In this video, we are going to learn about racks in Ableton Live. You can group devices into racks. This can allow you to build unique instruments, create parallel chains of effects, map parameters to macro controls, or simply declutter the detail view. Let's take a closer look. To create a rack, select one or more devices, call up the context menu, and select Group. Alternatively, you can use the shortcut Command G on a Mac or Control G on a PC. I've now placed these MIDI effects into a MIDI effect rack. Grouping an instrument places it inside an instrument rack, and grouping one or more audio effects together creates an audio effect rack. You can place MIDI effects or MIDI effect racks before an instrument in your instrument rack. You can place audio effects or audio effect racks after an instrument in your instrument rack. Once you have created a rack, you can map different parameters by using up to 16 macro controls. To do this, simply engage the Map button at the top of your rack and click on the parameter you wish to use. Finally, click on the Map button underneath a macro control. Alternatively, you can simply right-click the parameter you would like to map and choose the macro control from the context menu. By default, we can see 8 macro controls in a rack. You can increase or decrease the number of macros you can view by using these plus and minus buttons. Clicking this button will show or hide macro variations. Macro variations allow you to store the current state of the rack as a variation. You can add as many as you like, meaning you can build your rack to include different variations of your original idea. Let's add a macro variation using this button. Now I'll move some macro controls and store another few variations. We can duplicate, delete, and rename variations using the context menu. We can randomize the state of the rack's macro controls using the randomize button. This feature is a great companion to macro variations, allowing you to quickly and intuitively build up a bank of sounds to compose with. You can recall your variations by using the launch buttons. These buttons can be mapped to a key on your computer keyboard or to a MIDI controller. Let's finish off by mapping the launch buttons to keys on my controller and then jamming along with my track to discover new sequences and ideas. Wow.